it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share some more easy everyday hairstyles. These are Parisian inspired. I found them from Instagram accounts, and the little accessories I'm using in today's video can be found in my online store, missysueshop.com. I will leave a link down below in the description box. Make sure to check it out. There's a ton of really fun hair accessories. Make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell, all the usual things, and let's get started. For the first half up style, I'm going to begin by dividing out a few pieces of hair to frame my face. Then I'm going to place my fingers at the tops of my ears, and I'm going to divide off the top section of hair. Then using a comb, I'm going to smooth down the hair around my crown. Now I'm going to slightly twist this top section of hair together, and then using my right hand, I'm going to place my pointer finger underneath the twist. I'm going to grip the twist between my pointer finger and thumb, and then twist my hand towards the right, upwards, while holding onto this section of hair. And this will create a little loop with the hair. Then holding the looped section with my left hand, I'm going to take a claw clip and clamp it over the section of hair right underneath the loop. And then I'm just going to pinch and pull small sections of hair around the crown to add some texture to the style and even out the crown section. For the next hairstyle, I've parted my hair slightly off center. Then I'm going to divide out a few small pieces of hair to frame my face. And then I'm going to combine the remaining hair together at the nape of my neck. I want to make sure to brush through the hair to remove any tangles so there aren't any weird bumps or gaps in the hair at the end. And once it's all combined at the nape of my neck, I'm going to twist the hair together towards the right. And then I'm going to bring the hair upwards, directing it towards the top of my head. Then at the center of the back of my head, I'm going to fold the hair downwards, laying it next to the twist towards the right side. Then I'm going to take my claw clip and clamp it over both sections of the hair, so there is a small loop of hair at the top of the clip, and then the ends are at the bottom of the clip. This is a great way to get your hair up and out of the way, especially when you're in a rush or on the go. For the next hairstyle, I've parted my hair slightly off center again, and I'm going to try and keep the part for this particular style. So I'm going to first divide out a few pieces around my face to leave down, and then I'm going to combine the rest of my hair together, bringing it up to the crown of my head. Again, I'm trying to keep my part, so I'm going to sweep the sides around my head instead of combing them straight back. And then once it's all combined at the crown of my head, I'm going to twist all of the hair together towards the right side. Then I'm going to wrap the twist into a spiral at the crown of my head, twisting the section of hair as I go and tucking the ends underneath the bun at the end. And then I'm going to take a hairband and wrap this over the bun so it sits at the base of the bun underneath the hair. And now I'm going to reach into the middle of the bun and find the hair that is coming straight from my head. And I'm going to pull this section in opposite directions so the bun gets tighter against my head. And then I'm just going to take some bobby pins and pin down sections of the bun so it sits flush against my head. I pinned down about 4 sections of the bun, and when I finished this look, I wanted it to look really effortless and casual. So I liked how all of the sections going into the bun were a little bit looser and not perfectly combed in. And then you can kind of shape the bun however you like the best. For the next hairstyle, I've parted my hair in the same spot again, slightly off center, and I'm dividing out some more pieces to frame my face like before. I'm going to take a brush and smooth all of my hair together, combining it at the nape of my neck. Now I'm going to twist it all together and wrap the twist into a spiral. So I'm twisting the section of hair while wrapping it clockwise around itself at the nape of my neck until it's all wrapped up. And then I'm going to take a hairband and wrap it over the base of the bun to hold it in place. And now I'm going to take the top section of the bun and push it down so it pops over the bottom section of the bun and hangs lower. Then I'm going to pull the top section of the bun closest to the hairband in opposite directions to tighten the bun against my head. And now I'm going to take my all-over pearl scrunchie from my store, Missy Sue Shop, and wrap this over the hairband to dress up the style and hide the original hairband. And once the bun is all done, I'm going to go back over the hair at my crown and pinch and pull on small sections of hair to add a little bit of texture to this part of the hairstyle. And this will also add a little bit of volume to help even out the hair at the top of my head. For the last hairstyle, I've parted my hair near the middle again, and then I'm going to divide off a small section of hair to use for my braid. So this is right next to the part line on the left side, about an inch or so back from the hairline. I'm going to split this section into 3 smaller pieces and begin a regular braid by crossing the side strands over the middle strand. And after the initial stitch, I'm going to begin incorporating hair into the top side of the braid, but I'm going to bring in a new section of hair on every other crossover. So I'm bringing in a section, then I'm crossing the side strands over the middle on both sides one time, and then when I get back to the top section of hair and I cross that over the middle, I'm going to pick up a new section of hair and bring it into the braid as well. I'm going to bring in about 4 pieces total to the top side of the braid, and after the third section is brought in, I'm going to incorporate 2 sections to the bottom side of the braid, picking up the first section right next to the braid, and then the second section a little further out from the braid so it creates a sweeping effect going into the braid. And then I'm going to braid the rest of the section a little further down and slide a bobby pin over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps and create a second braid on the right side of my head. So I'm picking up a small piece next to the part line, an inch or so back from the hairline, and I'm going to divide this into 3 smaller pieces and begin a regular 3-strand braid. On every other crossover with the strand on the top side of the braid, I'm going to incorporate a new section of hair into the braid until I've brought in 3 sections of hair. Then I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the bottom side of the braid, bringing in the first section from right next to the braid, and the second section a little further forward so it sweeps into the braid. I'm also going to bring in a 4th section to the top side of the braid as well, so there are 4 sections incorporated to the top side of the braid. And then I'm just going to braid the section a little further down, and then slide a bobby pin over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to do the bun portion of the hairstyle, so I'm going to combine the remaining hair together at the nape of my neck, and bring in the 2 braids so they sit out on top of the hair. Then using a hairband, I'm going to wrap this once over the hair, and then using my left hand, I'm going to spread the ponytail up and around the hairband so I can find the middle of the ponytail. Then I'm going to wrap the hairband over the hair again to form a donut shape with the ponytail. And I'm going to pinch the bun and pull the hair in opposite directions to tighten the bun against my head. And then I'm going to take the ends that are left sticking out and divide these into 2 sections. With the right section, I'm going to loop the hair back towards the side of the bun on the right side and tuck these around the hairband to form a loop. And then I'm just going to take the ends on the left side, loop these back towards the hairband like the previous section, and tuck them around the band to form a second loop on the left side. And once the bun is all done, I'm going to go back over the hair at my crown and pinch and pull on small sections of hair to add a little bit of texture to this part of the hairstyle, and this will also add a little bit of volume to help even out the hair at the top of my head.
That wraps up today's video. Let me know in the comments section which of the hairstyles was your favorite, and if you enjoyed this video or didn't, make sure to click the thumbs up or the thumbs down. Either way, it helps me out. Make sure to subscribe and click that notification bell as well, then you'll never miss any future videos, and I will see you next time.